Hello and welcome back to
the WedEd! And today is a very special day because it is our Laura's birthday! So I don't want to embarrass myself and start singing, but happy birthday!
Thank you so much.
In fact, I do have a little surprise. I might get it out right now. No. I might get it out right now. Just stay there. Wait a minute.
Right. Oh, sorry. God.
I'm coming back on. Okay, wait. You're not allowed to see anything yet.
Okay.
Let me move that there. Okay, it's a surprise. It's melted a bit, actually. Oh my God. I can't do it. Right, I'm going to have to pretend. Wait, let me get rid of that.
This is why in your wedding planning kit you need extra lighters.
This is why in your wedding planning kit you need extra lighters. Okay, happy birthday to you. So happy birthday.
Let me blow
it out. Right, we'll have this later.
Oh, thank
you. And I'm going to move out of the way because the box is really ugly. And
the broken.
Always have extra lighters in your wedding kit.
So yeah, a huge welcome back to our birthday podcast.
So I actually said to Laura, I was like, because it is actually her birthday today,
yeah,
and we are going to be putting this out later.
Yeah.
And I was like, are you sure you want to do this on your birthday? She was like, yeah, it's fine. And I was like, are you
dedication,
sure?
Dedication, guys.
Full on dedication. So tell us today what we're talking about.
Topic of today's podcast is all about wedding timelines and the importance of creating them.
So obviously when clients hire us, they're hiring us because we are making their wedding beautiful, we're coordinating their wedding, but ultimately every client that we ever speak to, one of the most important things for them is the smooth running of the event day,
yeah,
is what they say to us. Mm-hmm. They'll say, we just wanna come and we just wanna have fun. We just wanna attend our wedding like we're a guest. We don't wanna have to stress about anything. These are all the type of things that we hear when we speak to our clients sort of as the wedding gets closer and closer. Mm-hmm. And just to run through a really, really long list of what you would need to sort of look at in a wedding, from the guest arrival to seating them at the wedding ceremony, to the bridal entrance, which is really important, getting the music right, you know, getting the guests to come to do the confetti toss, mm-hmm, because it's a big photograph moment, to the recessional, the processional, and then going into the cocktail area, having family photos, getting the right people for the family photos,
yep,
then getting the bride and groom to go off and have their photos, and then sitting the guests, then speeches, then food. I mean, literally, we're not even at the first dance or the cake cutting. So from our perspective, it is really, really important that we work together with the clients to ensure that their wedding timeline is super smooth, mm-hmm, that they know exactly what is going to be happening, so that on the day they can relax, they don't have to think about it, and they can let us make sure that their wedding turns out exactly as they want to, hitting each step, ticking each box as we go along.
Yeah, 100%. You don't actually think about all of the things that really make a massive impact if they're off timing, mm-hmm, you know, with speeches, with music, especially, you know, with first dances. You know, you need to be there to make sure that these moments are set in stone and they're, mm-hmm, as per schedule, so that all the team are there and present as well. Because, you know, if there's a timeline set out, you say, okay, the first dance is happening then, or the cake cutting is happening then, the venue will know, for example, okay, we need to bring the cake out at that,
yep,
point, and,
yep,
the DJ will know, okay, I need to play this song at that, mm-hmm, point, and we go into intricate detail, don't we, for example, you know, signed, sealed, delivered, played at 7:01.
Yeah, literally.
But yeah, you have to be. You have to be like that. And, you know, this can really, you know, when it's done properly, it can really create that smooth transition, and guests don't notice if things are kind of off, if, you know, the music is on point and everything gets per the timeline. Mm-hmm. But I've got an example of this, actually. So we had a wedding earlier this year, wasn't it? Beautiful couple, beautiful wedding. It was absolutely amazing. But it was in the Bulgari Hotel, and the actual ceremony and the dinner, the wedding reception afterwards, was in the garden area, wasn't it? But as we spoke about previously,
I'm laughing because I know what's coming. We were talking about this recently, which is why I remember what you're going to say.
But yeah, so in Dubai, we've spoken about this before, haven't we? There's noise restrictions. So, and a lot of venues, the noise restrictions are around sort of 10:30, 11, complete cutoff.
It was 10:30. The cutoff was 10:30. Yeah.
So what did we do? So we thought it would be nice to have a nice transition to kind of walk the guests into the ballroom, not a kind of on the mic, okay, everyone needs to move inside now, because it's unprofessional. It kind of, you lose momentum, don't you? And this was actually, it was a French-Pakistani wedding, wasn't it? So it's a combination of cultures. It was absolutely incredible. So we thought we'd bring that element of the Pakistani culture and use it to our advantage to help create that transition. So we hired a group of well-known doll drummers. And I was downstairs with the DJ. And I knew that at, you know, 1 minute past 10 or whatever it was, we needed to play this certain song and then we needed to dim it down because the doll drummers would be making a surprise entrance. Nobody knew that these doll drummers were coming. It was a surprise for the guests. And anyway, so Hannah went off to the changing rooms where they was all backstage getting ready. And you know, I've got Bulgari team coming over going, you know, we're approaching cutoff. Is everything? Yep. I assure you everything's fine. I'm texting Hannah. I'm like, you know, are they coming? Like, do I start dimming the music down? And she's like, hold on. You know, still waiting. I'm like, come on. I've got the team in my ears. Laura, 5 minutes to go. It's going to be a complete cutoff. And you imagine if we cut the music off, it's just going to be dead silence. And it's a fail, isn't it?
So I'm with these dancers and drummers. And I think there were six of them. There was maybe two drummers and four dancers off the top of my head. And they'd arrived at the venue on time, but they'd come not prepared in their outfits, which is normal. Yeah. And we'd had the changing room for them. And, you know, they came and obviously they have a certain attire that they're wearing, and then they put their attire on and then they're getting their turbans ready. And it takes a bit of time to get it done perfectly. And I'm like, guys, please hurry up. Like, you know, time. And Laura's messaging me, Hannah, where are we? And I'm like, please just hurry up.
She was texting me like, Laura, they still haven't got their turbans on. I was like, oh, for God's sake. Literally, Bulgari team was stressing me. The DJ's going, do I play it? Do I not? Do I dim it? Do I not? And I'm like, I don't know.
So I'm like, Laura, we're walking down the corridor.
To be honest, I was half expecting Hannah to come in with a turban on and the outfits and just start dancing because to go and get everyone in. I mean, we've got to do what we've got to do. But anyway, so they all came down, didn't they? I mean, I'll try and insert a video because it was just such a good moment. They all came down in their colourful outfits and turbans well intact. And the guests absolutely loved it and they had this surprise performance.
But they loved it too much because then what happened is all the guests got up and started dancing with them and they're dancing outside. Yeah. And now we're on 10:30, or I think it was like 10:31 when they came out.
And imagine,
the restrictions are at 10:30.
The drums are even louder than the music, aren't they? Yeah. They're very, very loud and
so
powerful.
We're literally going to the drummers like, take them inside.
You mean Hannah at the stage,
take them inside, like, please. And but the thing is they're there to perform and they're there to really entertain, and literally the guests were so excited and so happy because there was a lot of Western guests that were there that probably hadn't ever had that experience before. Mm-hmm. So they're all up dancing, they were really embracing the culture, and we're going to the dancers and the drummers like, get inside. And then literally the Bulgari team are trying to join us. Oh, it's become a big running joke now.
We
talked about this the other day because we were in Bulgari having a meeting, and Rodrigo, who's one of the directors there, we get on with him so well, and we sat there having a tea in the afternoon just laughing so much about some amazing memories, which is one of them. So for sure, like Laura says, with a timeline, what we really try to do is to find ways to fill gaps to then take you to the next part of the timeline. Now, the reason why we kind of installed that is anybody that knows me knows that I absolutely detest silence. I hate silence. Even if I'm at home working on the laptop, I've either got a movie on or music on.
Yeah.
I absolutely hate silence. And in a wedding, I also hate silence, but I hate guests being moved with a microphone like, ladies and gentlemen, can you please move to the next room now? Like, it's just
robotic.
It's just so robotic. It's not our it's not the way that we do things at Couture Events. I know that there are a lot of cultures where they'll have like an MC and that's very typical, but it's not really something that we do. So we really try to create an atmosphere with music or with something that will move people on to the next part. And the thing is like I said in the beginning of the episode, there's so many things that you're considering from start to end. If you don't have that written down in a very, very clear timeline, it is absolutely impossible to remember to get things perfectly right.
Yeah.
It's impossible. So to give you a couple of examples of really, you know, how we go into detail with this. So we will sit down with a client when we sort of, I would say, what, 2 weeks before the wedding begins?
I think so, yeah. Because a lot of things can change in the planning process. And, you know, they suddenly decide they want to have this moment and this moment. So, yeah, I'd say ideally.
About 2 weeks. We've always got a clear idea of approximately when a ceremony would start and when dinner would start. But that's really the bones of it. And then when we really get into the intricate details. And I'm talking about for a ceremony, for example, which for me is one of the most important things that we plan and we get right, and it's concise, is the entrance. The bride is doing her big reveal in her dress. Everybody's waited to see her. This is that groom special moment. There's so much pressure on a planner's shoulder because, especially now with social media, you know, you have these massive moments that people want to capture on reels, and they want to see the groom's face
and
crying.
And you only get one shot.
You get one shot. You can't go back and repeat it.
Yeah.
So it's really about making sure down to the detail. So we did a wedding in Raffles on the Palm, and the groom wanted to do his entrance. Hi, Charlotte, if you're watching, by the way. I love you so much. One of my favorite brides. I don't have favorites, but she's up there. And the groom wanted to do an entrance, and then the bride was doing an entrance, and she had, I think it was 6 bridesmaids, and they were just absolutely amazing. And then we had a violinist that was playing at the ceremony. And the bride and groom weren't allowed to see each other before they walked down the aisle, but they wanted to walk down the aisle at the same, like, him and then her.
Right.
So, like, I'm literally got her here, and then one of the teams got the groom there, and then we've got someone else with the violin player. And there's so many intricate details that you have to get right. The music has to start at the right time. The bridesmaids have to go at the right time. The groom can't see the bride. And so on our timeline, it is literally, isn't it, Laura, like 15:01. The music starts 15:02. Like, it is that
everybody's
concise.
Got clipboards in the team with this detailed timeline, so they know that's how it's laid out.
Yeah,
I mean, that's also partly the reason why people do dress rehearsals before their wedding. I mean, I don't think it's as common really over here.
Definitely not. No.
Yeah.
No.
But I mean, that's why I know if you are quite nervous about the timeline, that's where a rehearsal could come in useful.
I think it's essential for the fragile brides who are a little bit more conscious of how they want their wedding to play.
Yeah.
So we did this one wedding. This was, this was back in the day when I really had just started out. And I worked with a bride called Cara. Again, if she's watching, I still stay in touch with her. We're very, very lucky. We stay in touch with all our brides. And she was a stickler for time. And I think what I've learned over the years, and I think what is really important if anybody's watching this and they're starting out, or they really want to really sort their timelines out to make them really spot on, I made a lot of mistakes in the beginning by not making sure that, one, I was in control of the timeline, and two, that I didn't prepare the brides in advance for how important certain things were, and to give them the trust that I've got their back.
Yeah.
That took a long time for me to really learn, honestly. And Cara, she had a destination wedding, and she was based in the UK, so everybody was flying out to a European country. And she, as she got to the airport, this is how hands-on she was as a bride. She handed all of her bridesmaids file a fax of their responsibilities on the day of her wedding, and literally, and it was like a full-on ring binder, like this. Like, literally, the bridesmaids told me, and we were having a good old chuckle about it. And she just really wanted her wedding to be perfect. She dreamt of it her whole life.
Yeah.
She'd actually been with her partner for quite a long time. He had 2 boys and she was like the stepmom, but they really had created this beautiful family together. And she really wanted this day to be really, really special. And what I hadn't learned at that point, if I'm being really, really honest with myself, I hadn't learned the importance of giving her the trust that I had her back covered.
Right.
But I also hadn't learned the importance of taking control a little bit so that she could sit back and enjoy a day. And she did enjoy a day. And even, you know, to this day, she, whenever we chat about her wedding, she says it was one of the best days of her life. But from an outsider looking in as the wedding planner, she was just so consumed in, what am I doing next? Where do I need to be next? What am I doing next? Mm. You know, I didn't have that experience. And I think that now that I do have that experience, and the whole purpose of doing this episode is to really give people the experience that we've learned to so that they can take it into their everyday life, is to make sure that you're so concise in how you plan your timeline.
Yeah.
But then you also build up the trust with the clients so that they know that you know where they need to be, so that they can go and they can have a drink and they could be talking, and then we approach them, okay, we're doing family photos now. Can you finish your drink and then come over? And they just know it's gonna happen. They don't need to go to us, when we're doing family photos, what are we doing? When are we doing this, when we're doing that?
They know it's being taken care of. Mm. And I think, I mean, I'd go as far to say as this is, if not the most, one of the most important factors about our job. I mean, people look at the bigger picture and they see, right, beautiful decor, creativity, meeting clients, going and sourcing venues, looking nice on the day, the actual wedding day, celebrating. But you are a wedding planner. Mm-hmm. You're hired to plan the wedding. Mm-hmm. And part of that is producing an intricate, detailed timeline so that that day runs as smooth as possible. There's always going to be hiccups, and make sure you leave space in that timeline to account for these kind of things that will come along the way. I mean, essentially, they can do it themselves. They're hiring you so that they can enjoy their day, sit back, and just trust that it's being taken care of.
Mm-hmm.
What would you say is the most important part of the timeline that you need to master?
I mean, arguably, it's all really important, right? Mm. I think that the big moments need to be chosen by the client, because for every client, it's very different.
Yeah.
For example, with social media, there's so much pressure on having these big moments, and there's new moments that keep coming. So, for example, years ago, we always used to be the cake cutting and the first dance was the big part.
Yeah.
But now with social media, the entrance of the bride and groom into the space, into the dinner, is now really important.
Yeah.
You know, there's certain things that there's a lot of pressure to make sure, like the confetti toss, for example. Like, a lot of guests will sit down and they won't know when they need to throw the confetti. Mm-hmm. The bride and groom might not know what happens. Do they walk? Do they stop? Do they kiss? Do they what? Like, so I think that managing beforehand, first of all, really important to sit down with the client and say, right, what are the most important parts to you? What photos do you want to achieve? Like, what are you looking for? We always get clients to sort of create a gallery of photos from all different, like, you know, photographers from all over the world. I love this photo. I love this one. What do you love about it? I love the way that they're kissing. So now we always recommend, if they're comfortable, a bride and groom, when they walk down the aisle, they stop for 2 seconds and they have a kiss.
They get that moment.
They get that kiss, because they're not so far up next to the celebrant. They're further down. All their family and friends are around them, and there's potentially confetti. So it's just a really nice moment to capture.
Yeah.
So it's really important, first of all, to sit down with the client and say, what is it that you're looking to achieve? What photos do you really want?
What's your most important factor?
Exactly. And then prepping everybody that's involved. A photographer and videographer have a huge responsibility on the day of a wedding to be in the right place at the right time.
Yeah.
Your timeline isn't just for you. It's to give them to the vendors beforehand so that they know where they need to be. The hotel knows when the cake needs to come out. The mm-hmm. DJ knows when the first dance song is going to play, and if there's another song that has to come straight after.
Yeah.
You know, there's so many things. And, you know, even though for me, there's certain parts which definitely I put pressure on myself. Like, for me, it is the ceremony, because that's the first entrance of the bride. It's the music coming in. It's then the celebration of them coming together, and then getting the music straight mm-hmm. when they have that first kiss to create that ambience. Right now, we're coming to the fun part of the wedding where people can really start to mingle and enjoy. Like, that, I put a lot of pressure on my shoulders. Once that's done, you always know, I'm like, it's done. The big bit's done. But there's obviously still more big bits. But for me, that's important. But like, honestly, it's so many things for me. It's the pre-planning. It's the pre-planning with the client. It's speaking to the vendors, getting them prepared, knowing, guys, 10 minutes, we're doing the cake cutting. Guys, 10 minutes, speeches start.
Yeah.
You know, it's to make sure that nothing's missed, because ultimately on the day, like you say, there's no second chance.
Yeah.
You have to get it right. If the groom makes a funny comment and as he picks up the microphone and the photographer and videographer are just walking to you because they're not ready and they've not been prepared, that moment's missed.
It's missed. And on the topic of photography, it's really important to sit down with the client beforehand and say, how long ideally do you want to go off? Because that can create a huge gap in the timeline. If the photography and videography team are just taking way too long, that's, you know, a lengthy period of time where the bride and groom are away from the guests, mm-hmm. and you can really feel it. You can really mm-hmm. feel it in the party. And some clients, I mean, we've got a couple at the moment that are even asking us, you know, can we do a pre-wedding shoot? They don't even want to leave the party at all.
I wouldn't want to. You spent all that money. Exactly. You know, you want to be there.
And everyone's there for you. And if you're not there, what's the point? You know, mm-hmm. like, so yeah, I mean, it's quite common now that people are doing, they're having two wedding dresses, for example, or two wedding suits.
And three? We've had a few with three.
Yeah, but to do that pre-wedding shoot beforehand, just to get, you know, a really detailed shoot and get the photos that they really want without having to rush back and worry about how the guests are feeling behind. So that's super important as well. I mean,
on that note, what is also really important from experience is making sure that the photographer and videographer know that they only have a certain amount of time. Now, the reason why I say this, and this is something that I've learned recently, and I think that we always, Laura and I were just saying actually not long ago, every event we learn something new.
Yeah.
And most recently what I learned from a couple, so they didn't really want, they weren't very camera confident at all. Mm-hmm. They were like, we want the photos, and they wanted to go on the day in their attire, but we don't want to go for very long.
Yeah.
Now, obviously, as a planner, you're also responsible for what's happening in the wedding party, as well as what's happening with them going away. Now, we had a couple of things that we had to plan during that wedding process. So we actually stayed at the wedding party whilst they went off with the photographers that we'd worked with a lot. Obviously, the most important thing for the photographer and videographer is to get the best photo and video that they can possibly get.
Yeah.
So selfishly, they are going to want to keep the bride and groom for as long as possible. However, it's down to what the client wants, which is what we have to manage. And we had this one experience recently, didn't we, where the photographer, videographer took the client off and we're like, where are they? We stayed with the wedding party because we had stuff to do. And half an hour passed. They only wanted 20 minutes. 20 minutes was on our timeline. Half an hour passed, 40 minutes passed. I'm calling,
and
calling.
And of course, you know, the bride and groom, they're not carrying the phones at this point, you know, and we can't get hold of, mm-hmm. the resort is massive, you mm-hmm. know. Where are they?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Ride on the loose.
So literally, you know, we're calling and we're like, listen, you know, what are we going to do? And I think what we learned at that wedding was the importance of saying to the photographer, videographer, which we do always prep everybody, but especially when you're working with those timid and shy brides and grooms that don't want to spend that much time.
Yeah.
This is your window. That is all you have. Then you bring them back, especially if we're not there in person, to say to them, get your ass back.
Yeah. Or at least communicate with us, you know, if something's taking a bit longer, say, oh, the bride has requested, you know, another location, give us a call and say, do you think we could squeeze another 10 minutes in and we can make time from our end? But that's the importance of, especially if we've communication with the timeline as well. So mm-hmm. we know we can make adjustments elsewhere and brief the team so nothing else is heavily impacted, because it's a domino effect. Yeah. If something slips up in the timeline.
But then I guess that's the importance of having the timeline in the first place. Because from our perspective, if we do have a timeline and somebody's late or something goes wrong, or I've had a bride once, she was an hour and a half late for the ceremony. I swear. Like, again, it was when I was very new in the industry and not as experienced as what I am now. And, you know, you could never sort of force a bride and be like, get out, you know, you're taking too long.
Put the turban on.
Yeah, get out. You can't do that. And what I learned during the wedding was that she's late for everything. Now, right. If I had known that from the beginning, I would have put in at least a contingency plan. So if she was as late as what she was, that I had water there, because no one had water,
right.
That we had more shading, because it was a ceremony in the middle of the sun, in the middle of the day. You know, that maybe I would have even not sat people as early. I would have just double checked that she was ready. You know, there's certain things that you learn as you go on that, you know, you just have to learn to manage, you know? So yeah, from my perspective, having that timeline and really, really, you know, getting it right and nailing it is really important. So Laura, to sort of finish it off, when I ask if anybody is starting out, what would you advise them to do in order to keep their timeline as accurate as possible?
I think, first of all, obviously, get the bones in there, like we've spoke about. So, mm-hmm. you know, those really key moments, ceremony, first dance, cake cutting, make sure they're put in place. But then after that, really sit down with the client like we do, you know, 2 weeks before and go through everything in detail. What moments are you looking to achieve? Because there might be something that they're expecting that you're not really quite aware of. Someone might want to say something. Know exactly who wants to speak and when. You know, are there any speeches at all, photography, really understand, because it really differs client to client. So sit down with your client and really understand the bones of it. And I think if you are obviously starting out, I mean, I experienced this myself. You can't just walk into something, expect to nail it straight away. So don't be afraid to consult another person in the industry. You know, this is what the WedEd is for. Mm-hmm. You know, ask us, our DMs are always open. Or, you know, have a listen to this podcast. This is super helpful and gain some advice on different topics. But yeah, don't be afraid to pick up the call or reach out to another planner in the industry and just say, you know, what advice can you give? Or can you oversee my timeline? You know, I've made a timeline. Mm-hmm. How does this look? And get feedback, because we're all super helpful, you know, and we're all wanting each other to succeed. So yeah, don't be afraid to kind of get a second look. Don't feel like you have to take it all on your shoulders. Mm-hmm. And a third piece of advice that I'd give is, you know, we've spoken about this on a previous podcast, is have a designated contact on the day. So whether that be, you know, a bridesmaid or a friend or the mother of the bride or something like that, speak with them also beforehand and make sure perhaps they have the timeline, a copy of the timeline, and mm-hmm. just make sure if it's someone on your team or just someone in the bridal party that knows exactly what's supposed to happen when. If you're not present, you know that someone else knows about it and they can take care of it. And overall, the timeline is a success.
Mm-hmm. Definitely. And also write it down, like make sure that written document. I mean, we can put a link, actually. We can put a link on the WedEd to what ours would look like, yeah. So people can see them and see how intricate they are. And, you know, write everything down, make sure that you're there. So literally when something happens, you can tick it off, you move on to the next one. So you don't yeah. forget anything.
What I think is really useful as well. So we did mention that we have clipboards, but also keep a copy on your phone, because mm-hmm. you can't always have that clipboard in your hand. You know, you're picking things up or you're stitching a dress up or you're helping with something, you know, and the amount of times we've left a clipboard on the top of a side somewhere. Hannah, where's my clipboard? You know, so, you know, have it in different formats, maybe a piece of paper that's folded and you've put it down your bra, you know, or on your phone, or it's on the clipboard, and just make sure you've always got it accessible.
Yeah, perfect. Well, I think that rounds up our episode today.
Yeah.
Once again, happy birthday.
Thank you. I'm not going to reveal my age.
I have one more little surprise for you later on, but I can't tell you what it is right now, mm-hmm. but it is something after this. So happy birthday.
Thank you. We hope
that you found this episode really helpful. If you do want any help with timelines, do let us know. Like Laura says, we are there for you. I'm more than happy to sort of help you. And if anybody is interested in having a copy of what our timeline looks like, let us know. We're happy to help.
Yeah, fling over your email address and we can absolutely send you a template just to help you get started. Mm-hmm. But yeah, thank you so much, guys, for watching. As always, we really, really appreciate your support. We can see our subscribers are growing slowly but surely, and it's really, really exciting for us. We do have something really exciting coming in January of 2024. Mm-hmm. So do stay tuned. As we say, this community is open just for you. So we want everyone to benefit as much as possible.
Mm-hmm. And our next episode, we have a very special guest. So yes. Keep your eyes peeled
yes,
for that.
Our first guest on
yep.
the podcast.
Yep.
So exciting. So yeah, stay tuned. And
like and subscribe.
Thank you.
Bye, guys.
Bye.